To address the places where our current visualization is lacking in terms of communicating our message, one of the key things to focus on is how do we efficiently and effectively communicate a change over time. Our static chart shows the trend over time, but what doesn't come across as clearly are some of the nuances in the data. One way to address this might be to try visualizing our data with finer granularity. Instead of showing the aggregate attendance for a given year, let's see how it comes across if we visualize every individual game and its attendance. As I mentioned before, the next task at hand is removing the code in dimple.js that deals with axes and coding it up in D3 itself. Well, this code here both creates axes and changes how the x-axis is formatted, we're simply going to remove all of it and build it back up in D3. In lesson one, we saw how to work with D3's extent and scale functions to convert data values into proper pixel values. The first step in figuring out how to draw our x and y-axis in D3 is to first find the extent of each of the columns which we'd like to visualize. In this case, our x-axis is going to represent the date column, and our y-axis is going to represent the attendance. Remember that the extent function finds the minimum and maximum for a given data based on what you return from the accessor function. In this case, as applied to our data, extent runs the function we've passed on each element of our data, in this case, the argument d, and based on what we return from this function, extent internally keeps track of the minimum and maximum values it's seen. The same principle applies to our attendance, and notice that we're using the same function, d3.extent, in both of these cases, but since the function we're actually running is slightly different, in the first case we're returning date, in the second case we're returning attendance, time extent and count extent are actually very different objects.